Hello everyone, welcome to our video today. My name's Brendan.
My name's Lydia.
Today we're going to be making a vortex cannon. Would you like to show everyone the cannon we're going to be making? What does it do? You're going to shoot the dinosaur. Wow! Should we see what we need to do for this video? And then we can use our pencil to tick things off the checklist. Okay, let's put the vortex cannon down and let's tick things off. Okay, the things for us to improve this video are still better lighting. I'm not super happy with our lighting. Let's tick the sub tick boxes first, and when all of those are ticked, we can tick the main one. Yep, so better lighting and also better microphone, because the microphones we've got are not very good. Say okay less often. In the last video I said okay 32 times. Okay, tick that. I just said okay, tick that. Tick this one here. Mm-hmm. That's not a tick. The third thing we need to do is speak a bit slower. We also need to make the videos shorter to aim for about 10 minutes instead of 15 minutes. That should be more watchable. Okay, tip number three. Mm-hmm. And what's the last one for things we can improve?
That little speak more. Can I take that?
Yep. Now we've ticked all of these, so you can tick this one is finished. The tools for this project, what tools do we need?
3D.
3D
printer. We're already using it.
Yeah, we've already got it started up. It's getting warm. We're going to use my old printer today because it's got a wider nozzle and it can print a lot faster. We got it ready, we can tick it.
Take
a big. Oh no, it's too big. We also need some scissors. We've got these ready. Mm-hmm. Okay. Have we ticked all of the tools we need?
Which?
Have we ticked both the tools? That means we can tick the big tool tick box. For materials, we need balloons. We have these super big balloons that they're 18 inch balloons, and they'll be able to cover the
Daddy top of our vortex cannon. Already tick this one. Material.
Mm-hmm. Okay, tick the balloons. We need some tape for taping the top of the vortex cannon. We've got that ready.
Yellow.
And I think we need some targets. This morning we drew lots of targets. I drew these ones. This one is one that you drew. This is your princess.
A flower.
Oh, the flower. Let's have a look at the flower. This is the flower.
Little tiny petals.
It's a pretty, oh yeah, it's got pretty tiny petals. There's a rainbow going over all the rainbow letters.
I erased the butterfly a bit.
That's okay. We can fix it later. We'll put these to the side. We've got the tape. We have the targets. Okay. The first part of the procedure is for printing the parts. So we'll tick this, we'll just tick the first one, we won't tick the other ones.
This?
Yep.
We won't tick this?
We'll tick print the parts.
This?
Yep. And then we'll go this way, we'll set it up on the computer, and then we'll send it to the printer.
And this is wobbling down to 32.
It's all the way past 32. Shall we go? We have links for the vortex cannon, target stands, and templates for creating the targets in the description. The resources for all our projects are released under the Creative Commons ShareAlike license, unless otherwise stated. If you'd like to use them commercially, you're free to do so. Just make sure you provide attribution and share our channel. We'd love to hear how our projects are being used. We have lots more interesting ideas coming in the future.
Hello! Hello!
Hello, cat!
Hi, Brendan!
What's the cat doing? Does he want to watch us make the vortex cannon? Okay, you can put him on the side and he can watch. Oh, let's show everyone the part we just printed. Here's our vortex cannon. There's no balloon on it. There's no balloon on it. Let's have a look. It printed okay, but we forgot to clean the glass when we printed, so it didn't stick to the glass very well over here. Luckily, it didn't come off while it was printing, and we don't have a mess of spaghetti. We've got some anti-projectile baffles in here, so that when kids pull it back and let it go, they can't put any things on the inside to shoot with. This should block it, but it may create some turbulence in the air. And we might not get a good vortex out the hole. So we're going to put this one together and see if it works, okay? If it doesn't work, we've got a backup one. So what's our next step?
But how about this?
We have to finish 1, 2, 3, 4. When these four are finished, we can tick this one. So this one is cut. We cut the balloon. Should we cut the balloon? And then we'll tick it.
Where do we cut?
I'll show you. I wonder if I can use the pencil to draw on the balloon. The pencil doesn't draw on the balloon very well. But I think we need to cut like this bit off. Can you see it? Don't get your fingers. Be careful with the scissors. Yep, open it again and cut. Open.
Quiet.
If it doesn't cut, you need to open it and try again. Oh, careful, you'll get my fingers. Almost there. Okay, big open. Now you can take it off. Put the scissors away and cut the balloon.
But I was going to cut the place down here.
On this one, we cut the back of the balloon and we pull the back of the balloon. But actually, we can cut the top of the balloon and then we can use this one to pull it. It makes it very easy to pull.
Then, first we got to tie this up.
Or we can tie it later. You can tie it now or you can tie it later. It's up to you. Do you want me to tie it? Hey, that's not on our procedure. Tie a knot in the top of the balloon.
We don't need to tick.
We don't need to tick that. The next one is we need to stretch this balloon over here.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Oopsie.
There we go. We can tick. It's not very straight, is it? Let's see if we can pull this on this side and make it straighter. Do you want to tick the tick box?
This?
Does that way sounds stretch the balloon over the cup? Yep. And the next one? Tape the balloon. Here's the tape.
Little tape.
Go round and round.
Here,
right? Yes, right there. You hold it and I'll make it go round and round.
Cut.
I think we can go around a few more times.
Here is enough.
We should also make the tape go close to this ridge so that the balloon can't fit over. So that the balloon can stretch, but the tape can't stretch. So when the top, it's gone around the top one time, then we can cut the tape off. Okay, we can cut the tape now. Press it all down nice and flat. We can tick the last box, then procedure, tape the balloon.
Now we can tick this?
Yes. Now the procedure is finished over here. Oh no. That's a big tick. And here's our finished vortex cannon.
So, this one's mine, this one's yours.
Yes, so we have one each. Let's give this one a little test. Should we shoot your princess and your flower?
Shoot all of them.
Shoot all of them. We'll shoot all of them soon. We'll just do this to test them. Okay, you pull yours, I pull mine. You want the princess, and I'll have the flower. Let's put the scissors away. Okay, ready, set, go. Ready, set, go. Missed it. Try again. I'll hold this for you and you pull it. Yes, we got it. The last step is to play. We've built it, we've tested them. Let's play with them a bit. Should we set up some targets and see if we can shoot them down?
Is it a big line?
That's a pretty long line. Do you want to see which ones you can knock over with your vortex?
If I want to knock over this room, then I knock over this puzzle.
Then you can say, I got the rainbow and the puzzle. Well, yeah. If you get three, you can say, I got the puzzle, the rainbow and the house.
Or if I got three, I can do... Or if I got three.
How about we just try and see what happens? Which one did you get?
Flower.
Ah, well done.
I got one. And I still got six. One. Oh, I got five. Yes.
You have five?
Yes, try one.
Try shooting another one.
Okay. I shoot five.
How did you do that?
Because I put... Like that. Can I take it?
Yes, we finished shooting down some targets. Are you making an X or a tick?
Tick.
Okay, another big tick. What's the next step? Using a humidifier. We'll see if we can shoot some smoke rings with water vapor. Who's trying first, me or you?
Me.
Okay, let's get our humidifier and we'll turn it up. It's... Wow, look at that.
A fountain.
It looks like a fountain of steam. Get your cannon and see if you can shoot some smoke rings at Mum.
I need some. Is it enough? Yeah. Was that a good ring?
I think it was a pretty good one.
Some more, please.
We need to shoot them quite slow. If we shoot them really fast, we won't be able to see them. That yours is full.
Still full. Full.
That was a really nice ring. You are. Almost dropped it on the floor. We finished using the humidifier. And I think we've got some cool shots. That means we've finished everything. So what do we need to say? Say goodbye. Thank you for watching today. Please subscribe to our channel and like our video. Are you going to say bye-bye?